Jesus the Christ, bless the followers of Christ. I thank God for your lives. I thank you for tuning in on today. And I tell you, this is going to be a reading, but I want you to know that it comes from a share that I've already recorded and I planned on uploading onto this platform. I recorded it about 2 weeks ago, and it stems from a study that I've been doing on and off in the book of Nehemiah for about a month and a half. And I haven't been studying consistently in the book of Nehemiah for a month and a half. I've been studying it, and then I've been meditating on it a lot. In fact, I've meditated on it more than I've studied it. You know, you get to a point, and sometimes you just have to chew on things for a while and really think about it. And so if you're not familiar with the book of Nehemiah, I'll just give that to you briefly, and then I'm going to move forward from here. The book of Nehemiah, it features Nehemiah, who was a cupbearer for the king. And Nehemiah was broken because the city of Jerusalem, the walls of that city had been burnt and had just laid in ruin, and nobody had gone to repair the walls of Jerusalem. And so, long story short, he gains favor from the king that he served. The king gave him everything that he needed to rebuild the city, and he goes to rebuild the wall, and he goes to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. So he goes, he takes men with him, the king sends out some assistants and everything that he needs to go from province to province, and he gets to Jerusalem and he begins to rebuild the wall. And while he's rebuilding the wall, mockers rise up. And mockers and scoffers begin to mock and scoff at the work that they were doing. And while they were mocking and scoffing, Nehemiah and his crew never came down from the wall. They kept their focus. They continued to build the walls of Jerusalem. And so I think of it because it pertains to work. And so many of you are experiencing a lot of negative experience on your job. In fact, I entitled the video Wicked Persecutors. And even you may encounter wicked persecutors, not only on your job, but even in everyday life. And I want to say this, one of the things I like about YouTube is that I don't know what's going on YouTube. And I really like that because it helps me to be free in Christ. Amen. And to have a good conscience towards God. And see, when I say a good conscience, meaning that when you're sharing something, you know that you're sharing because the Lord is giving it to you to share, and not because of your involvement in the social scene on YouTube. I thank God that everyone that I've ever communicated with on this platform, and which I communicate with very few people, especially these days, and most of the communications takes place in the comments. And even when I get PM, sometimes I just don't have time to read it, or sometimes I don't read if I know I'm getting ready to do a share. And the reason why I do that is because I don't want, you know, sometimes when you read something and it may be on the very same subject that you were just about to share on, and it'll cause you not to share it, at least me, because I may say, oh, well, I don't want to, you know, Lord, you know, I just don't want any interference or any problems. I want to flow freely. So I've learned and taught myself, don't read PMs until after I've done certain things. Okay, that's just the way I handle it. But I do know that, I do want to say that the people that I've shared PMs with, I can tell you without a doubt, those people have never come to me with any foolishness. They've never come to me with any, you know, junk. If they've shared anything, they've shared only their own personal experience. And I thank God that I can boldly say that no one has ever come to me with any nonsense. And I say that to their credit, and I think I say that to my credit as well, because it says to me about them that they are not that kind of person, or at least they know not to bring that to me. And it says to me that they know not to bring that to me. All right, so I thank God for that. With that said, I don't like to share dreams, but I do want to share this with someone. And I don't know in what scene it was, but I do know the person. I'm not going to share who the person is, but I do want to say this to you. The Lord be with you, and the Lord encourage you and strengthen you. And I think this applies to many people, okay? But the vision that I had of you is that you were carrying a huge container of water. Huge container of water. And water represents the Word of God, the living Word of God. And the water was very, very heavy, you know, because water weighs a lot. And the container that you were carrying was a huge container. So based on the size of the container, I could just guess the pounds that was in that water was at least 100 pounds. If you carried water on your head before, which I've had, I pretty much can tell the weight of a container. And so based on the size of that container, I knew that that container was at least 100 pounds, okay? So the person was carrying the water, and so they stopped for a moment just to rest and regain their positioning with the container, and someone approached them. And the person that approached them appeared to be a person, but it wasn't long before I could see from where I was that it wasn't a person. It was actually a prince, a spiritual entity, okay? And that spiritual entity began to threaten the person. I'm not going to say what it said to them, okay? But I want to encourage you to keep holding fast to the Word of God. Continue to carry the Word of God. Continue to share the Word of God. And when wicked persecutors rise up against you, you just hold fast that God is your strength and He is your source. He's your supply. He's going to continue to hold you up. As Moses' arms were held up and those in the wilderness, your arms are going to be held up by the Lord. He's going to strengthen you and help you to continue to carry that word. And wherever, and it wasn't in a building setting, you were just moving about with this container. So I encourage those who are carrying the Word of God, when wicked persecutors rise up against you, put your hope in God, put your trust in Him. Even when you're weary, the Lord will uphold you. He will sustain you. He will keep you. He will be your guide. Remember, you are carrying the precious living water of God. And no matter how the devil threatens you, he cannot do anything to you. The Lord is your shield. He's your buckler. He's your help. He's your protector. He's your God. He's your defense. And remember, it is His word that you're carrying. And Satan can't do anything to the Word of God. Amen. In fact, the scripture says we can do nothing against the truth, and we know that the Word of God is true. Amen. So just hold fast, stand strong. The Lord is your hope. The Lord is your guide. And when you get into trouble and you need some words to encourage you, I would encourage you to read Psalms 37. And I'm just going to read a few verses of it for you, okay? Just Psalms 37. When wicked persecutors arise up against you, just hold fast to God's word. But Psalm 37 says, "Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good. So shall thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and He shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in Him, and He shall bring it to pass. And He shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for Him. Fret not yourself because of him who prospers in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass." Let me just stop there. There are some people whose total aim is to bring about wicked devices. They can't sleep, the scripture says, unless they have caused someone to fall. And then when they sleep, their sleep is taken away unless they've caused someone to stumble. And when they fall asleep, finally, they can't really rest because they haven't caused anyone to fall. You have to know who and what you're dealing with. No matter if you're on your job, in the world, in the church, wherever you are, you just hold fast to that living water of God. And if you have to take time to refresh yourself with that living water, you do so. Amen. So I'm not going to read it all, but I wanted to encourage you with Psalms 37. And I would even encourage you to read Psalms 35. Give me just a minute to get there. Psalms 35. And you be encouraged in God. He's going to keep you. He's going to strengthen you, and He's going to be your protection. Psalm 35 says, "Plead my cause, O Lord, with them that strive with me. Fight against them that fight against me. Take hold of shield and buckler and stand up for my help. Draw out also the spear and stop the way against them that persecute me." Remember, wicked persecutors. "Say unto my soul, I am thy salvation. Let them be confused and put to shame that seek after my soul. Let them be turned back and brought to confusion that devise my hurt." Amen. Verse 5. "Let them be as chaff before the wind, and let the angel of the Lord chase them. Let their way be dark and slippery, and let the angel of the Lord persecute them." When you encounter wicked persecutors, begin to call on the name of the Lord and begin to declare the word of God and declare that the Lord will send forth his angels to persecute them. You hold your peace, you stand fast, you continue to carry the living word of God, but you let the angels of the living God persecute those who have made it their job of persecuting you. Amen. And remember that they are not persecuting you. They are persecuting that living water that you are carrying. The person that was threatening this person carrying the water, they were threatening them because they were carrying the living water of God. The water that was even heavier than them seemingly. Amen. They couldn't even handle it, but they were carrying it with all that they had. You continue to carry the word of God with all that you have, and God will move heaven and earth and even send forth his angelic forces to persecute those who have made it their job to persecute you. Amen. So be encouraged. I'm not going to name your name. I'm not going to even email you. I thought about it. I'm not going to do that. But I know that the Lord will cause you to hear this. And when you do, I know that you're going to be strengthened. And I believe that is more than one person. Amen. So God bless you all. Be strengthened in the Lord. And the Lord be your defense. The Lord be your shield. The Lord be your buckler. The Lord be your help. The Lord be your hope. The Lord be your joy, which is your strength. Amen. Never let them see you sweat. God bless you all. Have a blessed week in the Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen.